It stands out that the only inner rocky planet with a proper moon is Earth. Mars's moons are tiny and very much unlike our moon, more like asteroids, and Venus and Mercury lack a moon altogether. This may indicate that forming moons may not have been easy for inner solar system planets, and that's if we can even call our moon a moon. The Earth-Moon system may be more accurately described as a double planet. That might make our system rare, and also eyebrow-raising in this regard is just how our moon formed through a chance glancing blow with a Mars-sized object early in Earth's history. While very likely not unique in the universe, that seems unlikely to happen very often in the galaxy, and it seems even less likely that it would happen at just the right time as to create the conditions of this world as we know them today. Because of this, our situation seems unusually special, even more so when you consider that it happened to a habitable planet that ended up with life on it. So this presents a question: what would Earth be like if it had no moon? The answer is very different indeed, and it may have ended up so different that life itself may never have appeared on this planet at all had things been otherwise. Without the moon, it's possible that Earth might be lifeless today. The most obvious difference would be the lesser tides. Before we get into this, it's worth noting that the tides are not solely an effect of the moon. In fact, about a third of the tidal effects that Earth experiences are in fact from the sun's gravity, with the other two-thirds being an effect of the moon's gravity. So the tides would not completely disappear, rather they would be muted and quite different. But within the question of tides is a problem. They may have been a direct contributor to the genesis of life on Earth. It's thought that early in life's history on Earth, the chemistry that led to life occurred in tidal pools. It's thought that once life arose, it was because of the tides that early life was able to spread from one pool to another, ultimately allowing for it to colonize the rest of the planet. Think of it as a chemical colonization of tidal pools, and without the presence of the moon and tides, this process may not have been able to happen. The sun's tides may or may not have been sufficient to do this on their own, but there's another effect on life here. The tides also help to agitate the ocean and churn. This is extremely important in the distribution of nutrients in the ocean, and without the effect, quite a bit of oceanic life on Earth wouldn't be able to survive. We would have dead zones, and we do in fact. The Black Sea's circumstances are such that it has an anoxic dead zone below a certain depth where very little can survive, which leads to wooden ships and even human bodies, it's thought, to last preserved for thousands of years because there's literally nothing down there to eat them. It's worth noting that the Black Sea represents a very special circumstantial case, making it unique on Earth. It's thought to have been substantially altered very recently, well within human prehistory, due to an influx of water from the Mediterranean when the two bodies of water connected. And the Black Sea does have tides, of course. Its dead zone is created by the dynamics of the merger of two bodies of water. But imagine if all our oceans were like that, where the tides just weren't large enough to agitate nutrients. Without nutrients, most of the bacteria couldn't even survive, much less oxygen-dependent fish and just about anything that isn't microscopic in our oceans. But there would be more profound effects on Earth if the moon wasn't present. One is that the Earth used to rotate significantly faster than it does now, and it was the moon's gravity that slowed it down. Without the moon, the Earth today would rotate every 8 to 10 hours, as opposed to 24. This would have made circadian rhythms in any biology early on very different, which at the very least would have telescoped through to life on Earth now. Reproductive and sleep cycles would be different, and for a civilization like ours, agriculture and food production would be radically different, if not impossible. And what of the seasons? For thousands of years, we've been dependent on seasons for agriculture. Even to this day, this is very carefully planned stuff. We typically plant just after the last frost date for whatever zone we live in agriculturally, and then we expect to harvest at a certain amount of time thereafter, but before winter for most crops. Any gardener knows that this is the cycle of things, but without a moon this would all be very different, and it wouldn't just be the plants. Life would have evolved very differently as well, so could a civilization arise on a planet with very different, perhaps more extreme seasons? That's an open question, but the moon was key in defining it here. Our agriculture could not be as it is without the moon. But there's more. The moon also serves to regulate Earth's rotation, and without the moon to regulate it, Earth's axis would wobble far more than it does now. This would make for a very different Earth, one where the polar caps would be extremely unstable and rapidly grow and retreat on an almost constant basis. Global temperatures would also vary wildly, and here's where the seasons would be completely thrown off, with some periods having possibly no discernible seasons at all, to much more extreme changes to temperature in a period with seasons, depending on how Earth happened to be oriented. This brings in questions of Snowball Earth, where once in its history it seems to have very nearly frozen over. The microbial life survived, but in a more extreme situation they might not have. It's anyone's guess if this might lead to a situation where microbial life arises multiple independent times on an unstable world, only to get snuffed out each time as the planet changes. Another temperature-related issue is that reflected light from the moon actually does have a measurable effect on heating this planet. It's slight, nowhere near what direct sunlight does, though it's still statistically significant, and Earth is somewhat sensitive to relatively small changes in global temperatures. Without this effect, what might our atmospheric temperature look like? And there's always the question of the effects of the tides on ocean currents, which play a major role in weather patterns. If the tidal effects of the moon weren't present, then ocean currents and weather would be immediately altered. Another thing to note is that early in Earth's history, when life first appeared, the moon was much closer to Earth and would have had stronger tidal effects. What effect that had on the early development of ocean life is not well understood, but one hypothesis suggests that rapid changes in salinity in the coastal areas of Earth might have been crucial to the chemistry of life early on, which in itself would have been affected by the larger tides at the time. Had lower salinity been an issue, life might not have taken the same path, at least, or it might not have gotten started at all. And there are other concerns. Without the moon, the core of the Earth would have spun faster. That would have made for a stronger magnetic field, and also would have made for very different atmospheric conditions, but also a different situation for biology if it was present, given that some species use the magnetic field for navigation. An interesting variant of this question to ask might be, what if the moon suddenly disappeared? This is of course beyond highly unlikely, but say it did, what would happen here on Earth? One thing is that the balances that exist within the animal kingdom would immediately be altered. Nocturnal predators often rely on dark conditions with varying levels of moonlight in which to hunt. With no moon at all, this becomes a serious problem. Not so much for their prey, however. Animals such as rodents tend to take cover when the moon is bright, so you might see a decrease or disappearance of nocturnal predators such as owls and an explosion of rodents due to a lack of predators. The loss of 2/3 of the tides, however, would be devastating for coastal sea life. Many species are dependent directly on the tides, such as crabs and mussels, but indirectly affected would be anything that fed on those animals, of which a great many land mammals living near the coasts do. Beyond the immediate effects, the instability issues would assert over time as Earth no longer has the stabilizing effects of the moon. If some other immediate aspect of a calamity such as this didn't end our civilization, the increasingly unpredictable conditions of Earth might at least force us to head into space to colonize whatever we could. We might abandon Earth for Mars, or build giant habitats in space and forever forsake our world of origin. Biology itself would be very directly impacted if the moon went away, and might cease altogether if Earth froze over. Gone would be the forests and macrofauna, eventually leaving a microbial world, much like what Earth was like when life first began. But even then, it might be relegated to an environment deep down inside the Earth, and no longer be a surface phenomenon. Biology on this world lives in symbiosis with the moon. It's very possible that without the moon having been here since near the beginning, life here on Earth may have never come into being at all, and that includes us. As an aside, if we had no moon, we would be totally without a dumping ground for tardigrades. Recently, Israel's Bereshit spacecraft crash-landed on the moon. It was carrying several items of interest, including a roughly 30,000-page digital archive of various aspects of human civilization, along with human DNA, and thousands of dehydrated tardigrades. These samples were actually sealed in resin, and with tardigrades being among the most resilient of Earth's complex life, if they survived the crash landing, it's anyone's guess how long the tardigrades can remain viable. Perhaps decades from now, someone will visit the site and see if the dormant lunar tardigrade colony can be revived. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently plugging Event Horizon again. This week, my guest is Isaac Arthur for a long-form discussion of the Fermi Paradox. It's a great conversation, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.